Welcome to everyone, and thanks for joining this webinar in which I will show you how to create an hybrid mesh by combining BlockRanger and Griddle. So let's first start by looking at Griddle, the benefits and the limitation. Griddle is a powerful and easy to use Itasca automatic mesher developed recently. It's a plugin of the Rhino CAD system, so it benefits of the full CAD environment of Rhino, and it allows to create complex 3D geometries, producing unstructured tetrahedral or hexadominant meshes. An hexadominant mesh is a mesh that consists mainly of brick, which are the best elements for modeling plasticity in flat 3D. So, for example, for this tunnel model, you can see that the brick in white represent the main part of the volume, and then you have a smaller percentage of pyramid, tetra, and wedges, which are less adapted for modeling plasticity. The workflow for creating a volumetric mesh in Griddle is the following. I will show you an example for a cylinder. So, first of all, I create my volume. Then I select the surface and I mesh it using Rhino. Once I've done this, I select the mesh and I remesh it using Griddle. In this case, I can specify the size of the elements that I want on the surface. And once I've done this, I select the mesh and I mesh the volume using Griddle. And I output the mesh as a grid file that can be imported later on in Flat 3D. And here I have my model. Despite the advantages of Griddle, there are still some limitations, particularly in for the civil engineering works. One limitation is the fact that the Griddle is an isotropic measure. That means that when you specify the size of the elements, then you will have the same size in all directions. For example, if you create the lining of the tunnel using Griddle, and you specify a given number of elements across the thickness, you will also obtain the same size in the other direction, the up direction and the axle direction. That means that you will end up with a very high number of model elements. Another disadvantage is the fact that being an unstructured measure, you will also have tetrahedra elements in the lining, and tetrahedra are not the best element for modeling plasticity. You will prefer to have only hexa elements. So one way to get rid of this limitation is to use hybrid meshes. And this is the purpose of this webinar, to show you how to create an hybrid mesh combining BlockRanger, which is a mesher producing a structured mesh, and Griddle. I will then provide you an example on a tunnel model and give a comparison of performances between a hybrid mesh and a Griddle-only mesh. And then I will end with an example of application to the underground research laboratory of Monterrey in Switzerland. So, hybrid meshes are meshes that contain a combination of structured and unstructured meshes. For the example here, the structured mesh is used for creating the lining and the unstructured for creating the inner region of the tunnel. So for the structured mesh, you can use Flat 3D primitives, but this starts to be complicated when the geometries are complex, or you can use a building block, which is an integrated Flat 3D tool, or use BlockRanger, which is a Rhino plugin. And in this case, again, as for Griddle, you can benefit of the complete CAD environment of Rhino. Then, for the unstructured mesh, you can use a Griddle or a third-party mesher. The only requirement is that you should have conformal meshes. That means that at the boundary between the unstructured and structured mesh, you should have elements that share faces, edges, and nodes. And I will show you later on how to do this. So the workflow that I show you is consisting, first of all, of creating the lining using BlockRanger to give you a brief introduction. BlockRanger is a mesher that allows you to mesh simple solid like brick, wedges, and tetrahedra that are constructed using Rhino, and then give you a control over the number of elements on solid edges. An example, I create a box which is 2 by 3 by 4 meters in size. Then I click on the surface. I select BlockRanger. I can specify the size. And then I produce a grid file, which I can import later on in Flac3D. You can see that differently from Griddle, in this case, I have a structured mesh. So I can use BlockRanger to create the lining, and then I create the outer and the inner tunnel lining volume with Griddle. To go more in detail, I'll show you the sequence for creating the hybrid mesh for a tunnel system consisting of 3 tunnels, 2 of them with the same cross section and 2 with different cross sections. So using BlockRanger, I want to create the lining volume. So I start from the outer surface of the tunnel and I duplicate the edges. Once I've done this, I can offset the boundary of my tunnel and use the new polyline that is created to create the inner surface of the lining. In this case, I'm able to define the volume of the lining. Now, I can divide this volume in a brick that can be meshed further on by BlockRanger. So I divide in this case the volume into 1, 2, 3, and 4 brick. Here you can see the brick, the bottom left brick. And that's it. For the second tunnel, I do almost the same job. So again, I generate the inner surface and then I split the volume of the lining into brick. And then I also add 2 plane into intersection region to cut the polysurfaces to guarantee the connectivity between the different blocks representing the lining. For the 3rd tunnel, again, I do the same. And in this case, I decompose the intersection region in this way. So you can see here that in this case, this part was representing 1 brick before, which I cut in this way in 2 blocks due to the fact that the 2 tunnels have 2 different sections. I can add a cut plane to cut the created polysurfaces for defining excavation step in case I wanted to model a stepwise excavation. Also, I can assign name to Rhino layer, and this name will be used by BlockRanger when creating the grid. So, I select all my closed polysurfaces and I pass the command BlockRanger, in which I can define which is the maximum edge length, the minimum edge resolution. And the BlockRanger will create me a grid file that is exported as a grid file format. I can then import this mesh into FLAC 3D. You can see here that in FLAC 3D, the group name are taken from the name of the Rhino layers. So I have my different step of excavation. Now I want to generate the outer volume as well as the tunnel inner volume. To do this, I click with the right button on the zone and then I select export as a DXF file. I open again Rhino, in which I imported the DXF, and I separate the exterior surface mesh from the interior surface mesh, respectively on the left and on the right of the slide. Now, I want to generate the outer volume mesh. To do this, I create a box which is surrounding the tunnel and which will represent the boundary of my model. Then I extract the polyline representing the tunnel boundary at the tunnel ends, so the polyline that are here. And I use this polyline to cut the surface of the mesh, the surface of the box. And then I mesh the box using Rhino. Now, I have to remesh the mesh of the box using Griddle. As I told you before, when dealing with hybrid mesh, the important requirement is that the Griddle mesh is the Griddle and the BlockRanger meshes are conformal. That means that they are sharing the same faces, edges, and nodes at the boundary between the two. So to force this, I take the exterior surface mesh of the tunnel, which was created by BlockRanger, and I explode this mesh. Then I surround every element of this mesh by polylines, which will be considered as hard edges when remeshing with the Griddle. So once I have done this, I select all the meshes, the mesh of the box, plus the mesh of the tunnels, plus all the polylines. So every polyline that is surrounding the exterior elements of this mesh. And I remesh using gsurf, which is a command of Griddle. I end up with this mesh. And once I have this, I can use gvol to create the volumetric mesh, which I export as a grid file. I do the same type of job for the interior surface mesh to create the inner volume of the tunnel. In this case, I also include the separation surfaces between the different excavation steps, so that later on I will be able to simulate a stepwise excavation. And finally, I import in FLAC 3D the three meshes, so the mesh of created by BlockRanger for the lining, the outer and the inner Griddle meshes. I show you now a comparison of performances between a mesh created by only using Griddle or an hybrid mesh. So the hybrid mesh is on the left and the Griddle only mesh is on the right. You can see that an hybrid mesh has 5 times less elements than a corresponding Griddle mesh. Why this difference? The difference is due to the fact that when creating a mesh by only using Griddle, you have to specify a size which is small enough to ensure at least 3 to 4 elements across the thickness to properly capture bending action on the lining. So since Griddle is an isotropic measure, you will end up with many elements across along the hoop direction, as well the axial direction, because Griddle is isotropic. Whereas if you create the mesh for the lining using BlockRanger, you can decide how many elements you want along the radial direction, the hoop direction, and the axial direction. So in this case, you can see that for BlockRanger, you have 9 and 9 elements across these two directions, whereas in Griddle, you have 20 and 20 elements. Another slide showing the same. So you can see that for an hybrid mesh, you have a regular mesh with 4 elements across the thickness, whereas for a Griddle, you have a structured lining mesh with a number of elements which is across the thickness, which is ranging between 1 and 3. So here is only there's only one element, and this is definitely not enough for correctly computing the stress results in the lining. So not only the Griddle only mesh is bigger, but also it will be less accurate in terms of results due to the discretization of the lining. If on this example I run a simulation to give you an idea of the corresponding time, I can see the following results. So for the short term, I consider undrained condition by excavating step by step the tunnel and keeping deactivated the fluid process. And then for the long term, I consider drainage condition by first calculating first running the fluid analysis over a given period of time, in this case 1 year, by deactivating the mechanical process. And then I switch off the fluid process, activate the mechanical, and calculate the mechanical equilibrium. So if I look at the comparison in terms of time, I can see that for the short-term condition, I have a calculation time which is 5 times higher for the Griddle-only mesh. This is because the Griddle-only mesh has 5 times more elements. So the times are almost proportional to the number of elements. For the drained, so the long-term condition, anyhow, the Griddle-only mesh leads to 9 times longer calculation. Why this? For when you run a fluid analysis, the calculation time is related to the fluid time step. And the fluid time step is related to the ratio between the volume and the sum of the surfaces of the elements. Now, a Griddle-only mesh is a worst ratio. That means a smaller fluid time step. So not only the CPU time of a Griddle-only mesh is longer because you have much more elements, but also is longer because of the smaller fluid time step. Now I give you a real example of application to the Monterrey Underground Research Laboratory. It's a mesh that we have created recently for Swiss topo with the purpose to reduce the calculation time for fluid analysis compared to a previous grid that was generated by only using Griddle. So the solution that we have proposed is to create an hybrid mesh, allowing to better control the quality of the mesh on the tunnel boundary where most of the elements which are limiting the fluid time step are located. As I showed you before, we have created a ring of zone on the tunnel periphery by using BlockRanger. And then by using Griddle, we have created the rest of the rock mass, including the geological layer and the topographic surface. So in this case, Griddle is quite efficient because it allows you to deal with these surfaces. The first test has shown that the fluid time step is increased by a factor of 300. That means that shorter calculation. So in conclusion, Griddle is a powerful tool for creating meshes for complex 3D geometries, but it has some limitation in civil engineering works where one wants to have a full control on the mesh for the structures. The combination of different meshing tools, structured and unstructured mesher, represent an efficient and very interesting solution in terms of quality of the mesh, number of the elements of the model, calculation time, particularly for hydromechanical calculations, and the quality of the result, of course. This was my last slide. I thank you for your attention, and if you have a question or comment, please send me a mail. Bye.